There are million and different kinds of animals in the world, and a systematic study of animal kingdom necessitates some scheme of arranging them into groups and classifying them. Zoologists classify the animals based primarily on structural characters. Those animals with certain characters in common are classified into one group. Hence, animal kingdom is divided into more than a dozen major groups called phyla. Insects belong to phylum Arthropoda. Hence, ordering the organisms into hierarchy of categories known as classification. The major categories used in the animal classification are phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. Sometimes, in between two major categories, intermediate categories are also present. For example, subclass and superfamily. These major categories used in animal classification are also called as taxa. An illustrative example of the major categories for the insect, European corn borer shows the following classification: phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Lepidoptera, family Pyralidae, genus Austenia, species Austenia nubilalis. Taxonomy is a related science that involves theoretical basis for classification and study of classification themes. Specialists working in the taxonomy classification are called as systematists. The study of the diversity and classification of organisms is called systematics. Hundreds of insect systematists around the world work daily on this task of collecting, studying, naming, and classifying new species of insects. Now we are going to see the objectives of classification. The major objective or application of classification is the identification of insect specimens. Classification allows us to order what we learnt about insects and to compare and contrast characters. From these comparisons, we formulate predictions about the relationships, both evolutionary and ecological. For instance, members of the same species behave similarly in food habit, tolerances to environmental extremes, development patterns, etc. A group of similar species put together in a higher category called genus also could be predicted to share their similar ecologies and to have evolved from common ancestor. Moving to higher and higher groupings in classification, we expect more and more diversity within the grouping. Identification of a major group such as insect orders can usually be made easy, and at a glance we can fix the order. But finer identification at genus and species level will require use of keys. Correct identification is the very important one for the insect as pest, so that correct management practices can be formulated. Without identification, we have no basis for predicting the injury and also to advise on management. Next, we will see what is meant by nomenclature. Major categories such as phylum, class, order, family, genus consists only one word, whereas a species is composed of two names, a genus name and a specific name. Hence, the scientific name of a species is binomial. The nomenclature, which means the naming of a species, is called binomial nomenclature, which was advanced by Swedish naturalist Carolus Linnaeus in 1758. Strict rules and conventions apply for name assignment, and they are named as International Code of Zoological Nomenclature. Therefore, we can see the species name written for European corn borer, for example, as Austenia nubilalis, Hubner. The author who described the species originally placed in the genus will be without parenthesis. subsequently the author who describes the species and he may place in another species. In this case, the author's name is within the parenthesis. Scientific names are Latinized and usually refer to some characteristics of the animal or group named. The binomial species is always printed in italics. If handwritten, it is underlined to indicate the italics. Besides the names of the genera, higher categories begin with capital letters. But the specific name of a species and subspecies names are always should begin with lower case letters as seen in the subspecies, namely Diabrotica, Undecim punctata, Undecim punctata. In this case, the first name is genus name, the second name is species name, and the third name is subspecies name, which is a group of individuals of the same species that have differences in body form or color and geographical distribution. A frequently used name for the species is called the common name, which is not covered by formal rules of nomenclature. The name European corn borer is a common name. Similar to nickname, common names for same species may differ in different localities, whereas there is only one scientific name. A list of common names approved by the Entomological Society of America are not necessarily followed in other countries by international scientific community. The species category plays an important role in this system of classification. It is only the category that is real and natural group. The species is a complex unit and it is defined as a group of interbreeding individuals that are similar in body character and that produce fertile offspring. These groups are reproductively isolated from other such groups. So far, we studied the principles of insect classification. Now, we are going to study and learn about general classification of insects. There are 29 orders coming under class Insecta. Among them, about 7 orders are considered to be very important and considered as major insect orders. Since many harmful insects from these orders assume pest status, causing problems to the crops, human and animals. The class Insecta is divided into two subclasses, namely Aetericota and Terricota. Subclass Aetericota. The subclass Aetericota includes mostly primitive wingless insects. There are few orders coming under this subclass. They are order 1 Protura, commonly called as Proturans, 2 Columbola, called as Springtails, 3 Diplura, called as Diplurans, 4 Thysanura, called as Bristletails. The Aetericota orders are mostly primitive insects and wingless. They grow with very little change in form during development. This pattern of life cycle is called no metamorphosis. They have mouthparts housed within a cavity. Such mouthparts are called as endognathous, whereas in all other insects, the mouthparts are exposed and called as ectognathous. Distinguishing characters of Aetericota orders. Among the orders of Aetericota, Taxonura, Columbola are of importance. Order Taxonura. They are commonly called as bristletails. Medium size, 7 to 19 mm. Body is flattened. They have two long cerci and a medial caudal filament at the end of the abdomen, giving appearance of tails. The skin is covered by soft scales, giving color of silver, hence called as silverfish. They are found in woodlands and a decaying bark. They are minor household insects. They cause damage to books, posters, charts, feeding on gummy starch materials used in binding materials. Also, they are seen to feed on starch clothing, curtains, starch paste used in wallpaper. They have ectognathous chewing mouthparts. Order Columbola. They are commonly called as springtails. Columbolans are small, 0.2 to 10 mm in length, grey to off-white in color, sometimes green or purple also. Body shape is round, long, slender or globular. Mouthparts are chewing type. in some insects modified as sharp stylets. They have a structure called furcula arising from underside of the abdomen near the tip. It is always cocked by a clasp called tenaculum. When spring tail is disturbed, the furcula is released and propelled to jump. Spring tails, the columbolans, are found mostly in moist, damp environments, including debris and soil, edges of ponds, snow, fungal encrustations, mushrooms. One or two species are also pests and garden vegetables. In tropics, they are seen under potted plants in the moist soil environment. Next, we will be moving to subclass Pterycota. They are winged and secondarily wingless insects. Pterycota are variously divided by systematics into large groups of orders, namely Exopterycota and Endopterycota, based on presence or absence of wing flexing mechanisms, internal or external growth of wings, or complexity of growth and development process. Orders with individuals that have simple form of body change during the growth and external wing development are placed in Exopterycota. Those orders with complex changes in its body form and internal wing development are placed in the division Endopterycota. The distinguishing characters of insect orders of Exopterycota. First order, Ephemeroptera. They are commonly called as mayflies. They are mostly primitive of the winged insects. They are characterized by triangular, net-veined, membranous wings and two or three filamentous appendages at the tip of the abdomen. Ephemeropterans are soft-bodied, 10 to 40 mm long with short bristle-like antennae. Mouth parts are reduced and non-functional in the adult. Adults are found near lakes, ponds, streams and are attracted to light in large numbers. Young ones, called as nymphs, develop in water and they are aquatic with leaf-like gills and are used for swimming and respiration. They have chewing mouth parts, feeding on algae and debris. Adult mayflies emerge from water in large swarms. Adults mate females and then start laying eggs. Mayflies do not feed anything and they die in a day or two. Therefore, the name of the order, Ephemeroptera, originated from the words finera, means a day, short-lived. The aquatic young nymphs are serving as food for the fish and other aquatic animals. Mayflies are also useful as indicators of aquatic conditions and concentrations of pollutants in the upstreams. Next order, Odonata. They are commonly known as dragonflies and damselflies. They are large insects, sometimes brightly colored and banded wings. They have net-veined membranous wings. Head is large with prominent protruding eyes. They have slender bodies, antennae and short bristle-like. The mouth parts are well-developed chewing type. Serrated mandibles for predatory feeding behavior. Adults feed on flying insects caught in flights like mosquitoes, midges, eye flies, small flying insects. Females lay eggs in water. Immature stages are aquatic and they may also prey on other insects and small animals in ponds, lakes and backwater and also freshwater streams. The period of immature stages to become adult ranges from 1 to 4 years. The order Odonata is divided into two suborders, namely Anishoptera called dragonflies and Zycoptera called damselflies. The suborder Anishoptera dragonflies. Adults are robust, heavily bodied, strong and well-controlled flyers. Male dragonflies establish territories that patrol in search of food and defend against other dragonfly males. While at rest, the wings are kept horizontal over the body. The dragonfly nymphs are aquatic, usually found in bottom of the lakes and ponds and mud slurry. They possess internal rectal gills acting as respirators and propellers. Nymphs are called as naiads. Next, the suborder we will see Zycoptera, that is damselflies. Damselflies are slender, soft-bodied, delicate when compared to dragonflies. Adult damselflies display a fluttering type of wing compared to strong directional flight by dragonflies. While at rest, the wings of damselflies are held together above the back parallel to the body. The immature nymphs are very slender. They possess three leaf-like gills at the tip of the abdomen. They are found more often near submerged vegetation than on very bottom of lakes and ponds. Next order in the category we see Phasmida, which are otherwise called as stick and leaf insects. Many systematics include the stick and leaf insects under family Phasmidae under order Orthoptera, as walking sticks as common name. Some raise them as an order. The insects of Phasmida are particularly striking in their resemblance to twigs and leaves. Some of the tropical species look very much like leaves and are often called as leaf insects. They are green with the enlarged leaf-like structures on the body with the veins like leaf-like. The structure helps them for camouflaging and mimicry. The stick insects are very long, elongated, even up to 30 cm in length. Some are spiny, slow-moving and stick-like or twig-like. Because of this camouflaging with the background of dry sticks and twigs of a plant. All stick insects are wingless. Exceptionally, a few species have a small or oval front wings and hind wings slightly larger. Invariably, they feed on leaves but not voracious eaters. Distinguishing characters of these orders, Dictyoptera, Dermoptera and Orthoptera. First, we will see Dictyoptera. It includes two groups of insects, namely blattids, that is cockroaches, and mantids, the praying mantis. Family Blattidae, cockroaches. They are relatively larger insects. They are oval and flat in shape. Numerous spines are present in legs. Wings are membranous. Legs are running and walking type. Antennae are long, filamentous. Reddish brown in color. Mouthparts are chewing type with strong mandibles. They are household insects living in drainage of kitchen, sinks and toilets. They emit a stinging odor, hence called as stinging cockroaches. They are active during night, nocturnal in behavior. They contaminate the vegetables, food remnants, food that kept on kitchen with filthy odor and smell. They remain in dark niches of cupboards, dryers, storage cabinets of kitchen mostly. Not all the cockroaches are found in human dwellings. Many are existing outdoors too. In general, cockroaches prefer warm and humid habitats. They breed throughout the year. Most species lay eggs in egg pods called uthika, which is sealed shell seed-like. The common species are oriental cockroach, Blatta orientalis, which is about an inch in size, dark brown in color, broadly oval with short wings. Next species, American cockroach, Periplaneta americana. This is fairly larger, 27 to 35 mm in length, reddish brown with well-developed wings, mostly found indoors. Cockroaches breed in hundreds, hence causing annoyance, allergic in houses, which need to be controlled and managed. Lot of chemicals and traps are involved in their management. Next family, Mantidae, which includes praying mantids. The body is elongated and the pronotum is lengthy with raptorial, spiny front legs. In general, praying mantids are predatory. It is said that the praying mantids are the only insects that can see or look over their shoulders as the head is highly movable. Praying mantids feed on many variety of insects, including their own members. They wait for their prey, keeping their front legs in upraised manner as if doing prayer for their prey, hence called as praying mantids. Eggs are deposited on twigs or grass stems in a hardened, buffy, papery egg case called uthika, which contains more than 200 eggs sometimes. Mantids are mostly tropical in distribution. different colors are present in praying mantids, varying from brown to dark colored, and some are green and mostly camouflaging, merging with the background of dark or twig or flower or leaves to catch their prey when they are near the mantids. Some species feed to death in ground to catch the prey. The size varies from 2 to 5 inch. Next order, Dermoptera. They are commonly known as earwigs. They are medium sized, resembling certain type of beetles since the hard exoskeleton is prominent. They are elongated insects with a pair of pincers like cerci at the tip of the abdomen. The front wings of the earwigs are short, elytra like or leathery. The hind wings are membranous, ear shaped, folded below the forewings. They have chewing mouthparts, some emitting bad odor due to foul smelling liquid emanating from glands in the abdominal region to get protection from enemies. Earwigs are nocturnal in behavior. Some are herbivorous, some are predaceous. There is a common belief that earwigs enter human ears and cause nuisance, hence deriving the name earwigs. Next order, Orthoptera. This order is of more importance in the point of pest status. They include grasshoppers, long-horned grasshoppers, crickets, mole crickets, katydids, and locusts. They are winged insects, sometimes wingless. The front pairs of wings are thick, leathery, called tegmina, and the hind wings are membranous, fan-like if unfolded. Mouthparts are typical chewing type with strong mandibles. Many are phytophagous. The growth and development are undergoing gradual metamorphosis. Some sound production is very common in Orthoptera, especially in crickets, which make continuous sound during night, causing nuisance. The wings are rubbed against forelegs to produce sound. This sound producing mechanism is called as stridulation for finding their mates. Orthopterans are mostly jumping insects. Family, Acridiidae, shorthorn grasshoppers or locusts. Grasshoppers are well-known insects all over the world. Antennae is short, thread-like, hind legs are modified for jumping. The egg-laying organ is ovipositor, which is very short. Grasshoppers mostly lay their eggs in soil. Grasshoppers are voracious phytophagous on plants, crops, grasses. The group locusts are very special type of insects having life cycle with two phases, solitary living in single and gregarious phase developing into large swarms of thousands and millions. They travel in air in swarms for long distance, and once settled they devastate entire vegetation on the ground, leaving the area into famine. Next family will move, Tetigonidae, long-horned grasshoppers. They have long bristle-like antennae. They include katydids, another long-horned grasshopper. Many tetigonids are having well-developed stridulatory sound-producing organs. So also, they have sound-hearing organ, ear-like organs at the base of the front tibiae. Such species produce a characteristic sound. Eggs are inserted into plant tissues. Most of the species are plant feeding. A few are predaceous on other insects. Rarely a few insects like Mormon cricket that feed on orange tree is considered as most outstanding pest. Sometimes pest outbreak of the species becomes very dangerous, destroying the crop completely. Next family, Grillidae, crickets. Grillids are well known for their chirping sound producing at night time. They are recognized by their long antennae and a lance-shaped ovipositor. They feed on wide variety of food ranging from plants to other insects. Sometimes they are cannibalistic. When household species enter inside, it causes annoyance to sleep by making chirping sound. Field cricket, grilla species are widely distributed groups. Most of the grillids are dark brown in color. Some are black in color. The family includes another important tree cricket called Eucanthus species, which inserts eggs in the bark and also stems of the trees and shrubs. Sometimes the young twigs break to die. Next family, Gyrolotalpidae, mole crickets. Mole crickets are brown colored insects with pubescence on the body. The size is about 1 to 1.5 inches. They have very short antennae. The front legs are very broad, spade-like with serrations. Mole crickets dig the moist soil and burrow inside mostly 6 to 8 inches below the soil surface. The most common species is Gyrolotalpa hexadactyla. The characteristic features of next order we are going to see Isoptera. They are called as termites. Sometimes also they are called as white ants. Termites are soft-bodied, light-colored. They are small to medium-sized insects that lead social life with well-developed caste systems like workers, males, queens, and soldiers. Both winged and wingless individuals occur in the colony. The wings, when present, are soft, membranous, reduced, wrinkled venations. Wings form, they are short-lived and shed their wings in 24 hours. After emergence from the place of the living called termitarium made of earthen mounds. The both pairs of wings are held flat on the body. The mouthwash are chewing type and metamorphosis is simple. Termites feed on wood, dried twigs, paper, cellulose of straw and anything of a plant source and are able to digest the cellulose material. They live underground mostly in social colonies by constructing earthen mounds above the surface and under ground chambers below the soil. Caste systems and social life of termites, reproductive castes. They include queen and king. They are highly developed insects. They have fully developed wings. They are the founders of the colony. They are produced in rainy season in large number. They set their wings in a day and are attracted to light. They are eaten by many predators like lizards and ducks. The successful pair of the termite of a male and a female mate and excavate to start the colony. Males are small whereas the female termites enlarges its body structure and becomes the queen of the colony. The size of the queen may be 3 to 4 inches, soft bodied, white in color, worm like in some tropical species. The queen termite starts laying eggs and live for several years. They lay thousands of eggs. Worker caste. The worker caste of the nymphs and sterile adults are pale in color. They are wingless, usually lack in compound eyes. Mandibles are small. The worker caste individuals perform the most of the works of the colony. They collect, they store the food, feed to the queen and soldiers and the newly hatched young ones called the nymphs from the eggs. They construct and maintain fungal gardens and knots. They build nests, passageways, various chambers, underground tunnels, galleries in the termitarium. Next, the soldier caste. The soldier caste consists of sterile adults which have enlarged heads and mandibles. They are larger than workers in size. When colony is disturbed, the soldiers attack the intruders, kill them with their mandibles. In some species, special type of soldier called Nasuti soldier is present. These individuals have the head prolonged interiorly into a narrow snout which acts as a weapon to attack the intruder and defend the colony. A supplementary reproductive caste are also existing in the colony. They have short wings, heavily pigmented than the primary reproductives. The supplementary reproductives also carry on extensive reproduction in the nest and supplement the queen in building the colony. Habits of termites. The termites frequently groom each other with their mouthparts due to the attraction of the secretions from the body. The food of the termite is composed of cast skin, fecal matter of other individuals, dead individuals, woody and woody products. Some termites are subterranean in habitat in moist environment. Some live in dry habitat above the ground. The subterranean forms normally live in woody, buried beneath or in contact with the soil. by connecting with the earthen galleries using moisture with the wood above the ground. The earthen galleries or tubes are made of dirt mixed with a secretion from a pore on the head. The nest may be entirely subterranean. Some tropical species of termites construct termite mounds called termitaria, sometimes 30 feet height above the ground. The dry wood termites, which lie above the ground without contact to the ground, live in posts, stumps, trees, buildings constructed of wood. Their chief source of moisture is the metabolic water resulting from the oxidation of food. The cellulose material in termite food is digested by myriads of flagellate protozoans, establishing symbiosis or mutualism mechanism. Some termite species harbor bacteria rather than protozoa. Termites engage an interesting phenomenon or a behavior in a unique form called trophallaxis. By this process, the intestinal microorganisms are transmitted from one individual to another individual. The microorganisms present in the digestive tract aid in the digestion of food of termites. In conclusion, we study today about the group of animals called insects, their classification systems, procedures and guidelines in their naming of insects. Also, we studied about basic insect groups, their development, life cycle, habits, feeding behavior, and their economic importance.